We often like to highlight players in an NFL draft that were passed up on and which teams took a different player before them, but today we're going to switch it up. Instead, let's take a player that went high and see who that team missed out on later. And who better to start the series about busts off with than the number one overall bust himself, JaMarcus Russell. First, I'd like to acknowledge that the majority of the people who watch our videos aren't subscribed to the channel. Help us out by subscribing and joining us on our way to 100K, because it's coming fast and you don't want to miss your opportunity to enlist in the J&D Army. This video has been one of, if not the most requested video we've ever had on the channel. Y'all have been asking for this for over a year, and finally, we had to give it to y'all. So, let's start it off by taking a quick look at the disaster of JaMarcus Russell. JaMarcus Russell attended Louisiana State University, where he redshirted his first year. The next season, he was primarily the backup, passing for 1,053 yards and 9 touchdowns to 4 interceptions. He earned the starting gig the next year and helped LSU to a 10-1 record after passing for 2,443 yards and 15 touchdowns to 9 interceptions. His junior year was the true year of JaMarcus Russell, though. He went on to be named first team All-SEC after recording 3,129 yards and 28 touchdowns to 8 interceptions. His pure arm strength and overall size at 6'6", 260 pounds, impressed a lot of teams, making him hard to pass up with the first overall pick. At the 2007 NFL Draft, the Oakland Raiders selected Russell with that number one pick. He made a few appearances during his rookie season, but for the most part, he just sat on the bench. He finally made his first career start in the final game of the regular season. He finished the year with 224 yards and a touchdown to an interception. Russell was the Raiders' starter in 2008 and showed some promise early on, but it went south. Oakland went 5-10 under him as he passed for 2,423 yards and 13 touchdowns to 8 interceptions. He got to continue to start in 2009, but was ultimately benched. Even after the new starter got hurt, the Raiders still decided to go a different option at quarterback. Russell finished the season with 1,287 yards and 3 touchdowns to 11 interceptions. Going into the next season, Russell was reportedly up to 300 pounds, about 30 pounds up from his rookie weight. The Raiders opted to release him after only 3 seasons, and no other NFL team claimed him, ending his career. Now, we understand the disaster of JaMarcus Russell, so who did the Oakland Raiders miss out on later in the draft? Well, only one selection after Russell, the Detroit Lions took one of the greatest wide receivers of all time, Calvin Johnson. Megatron was an absolute freak. He owns the NFL record for receiving yards in a season with 1,964 yards and has the most consecutive 100-yard games with 8. Johnson was a 4-time All-Pro and 6-time Pro Bowl nominee. Additionally, he is a member of the 2010s All-Decade team. Johnson spent his entire 9-year career in Detroit before famously retiring early at the age of 30. Right after Johnson, the Cleveland Browns owned the 3rd selection, where they took future Hall of Fame offensive tackle Joe Thomas. Thomas was an absolute monster. He is one of the best linemen in NFL history, surely on a fast track to the Hall of Fame. During the first 10 years of his career, Thomas made the Pro Bowl every season and was an 8-time All-Pro. He played 10,363 consecutive snaps, an NFL record. He didn't miss a single game until his 11th season when he injured his triceps. Thomas decided to retire that following offseason. He was named to the 2010s All-Decade team and was put in the Browns Ring of Honor. He is currently an analyst for NFL Network and does pre- and post-game for Thursday Night Football. Another future Hall of Famer went to the Minnesota Vikings at number 7. This is the first player on the list still playing, Adrian Peterson. He was a star from the second he stepped on the NFL field, going on to win Offensive Rookie of the Year. Peterson owns the NFL record for rushing yards in a game with 296 and is the only non-quarterback to win MVP since being drafted, winning it in an impressive 2012 campaign. He has been named an All-Pro 7 times and made the Pro Bowl 7 times. Peterson is a member of the 2010s All-Decade team as well. After 10 long years in Minnesota, Peterson has continued his career while bouncing around to the Arizona Cardinals, New Orleans Saints, Washington Redskins, and he currently plays with the Detroit Lions. With the 11th pick, the San Francisco 49ers took linebacker Patrick Willis. Willis is another future Hall of Famer. While he didn't make the 2020 class, don't worry, he'll get in soon. Willis stepped into the pros and won Defensive Rookie of the Year before going on to have a stellar career. Willis spent 8 years in the league, all with the 49ers, being named an All-Pro 6 times and making the Pro Bowl 7 times. He is a member of the 2010s All-Decade team. Willis was struggling with a toe injury in 2014 and decided to retire after the season. One spot after Willis, the Buffalo Bills took the second star running back in the class, Mark Marshawn Lynch. Beast Mode spent 3 years in Buffalo before he was traded to the Seattle Seahawks in exchange for 2 3-day picks. He became a legend in Seattle, going for over 1,000 yards in his first 4 full years. In his first season with the Seahawks, he had one of the most known plays in playoff and maybe league history. Against the Saints, he went for a 67-yard touchdown, breaking 9 tackles along the way. He decided to retire in 2016, but returned to play for the Oakland Raiders for 2 seasons. Last season, he played for the Seahawks again. In his career, he has been named an All-Pro twice and made the Pro Bowl 5 times. Next up, we have one of the greatest cornerbacks in NFL history, Darrelle Revis. Revis was taken 14th by the New York Jets before making his mark on the league. He spent 6 seasons in New York, but would return for 2 more seasons later in his career. Revis bounced around, making stops with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, New England Patriots, and Kansas City Chiefs. He won his only Super Bowl with New England. Revis was a first-team All-Pro 4 times and made the Pro Bowl 7 times. He retired in 2018 after 11 seasons in the league. Revis is a member of the 2010s All-Decade team. Late in the first round with the 28th selection, Joe Staley was taken by the 49ers. Staley became a staple for San Francisco, playing 13 years before retiring this past offseason. He was one of the most dominant linemen in the league during his career, being named an All-Pro 3 times and making the Pro Bowl 6 times. He was a member of the 2010s All-Decade team. Other than Peterson, the only other active player on this list was the 31st selection at the draft, Greg Olsen. Olsen was selected by the Chicago Bears, whom he spent 4 years with before being traded away to the Carolina Panthers. With the Panthers, well, he made his career, going for over 1,000 yards 3 times in 9 years while establishing himself as one of the best tight ends in the league. This past offseason, the Panthers released him and he signed with the Seahawks. In his career, Olsen has been an All-Pro twice and made the Pro Bowl 3 times. In the second round, the San Diego Chargers used the 37th pick to take Eric Weddle. Weddle has been one of the more underrated players in the past decade. He established himself as an elite safety during his 9-year tenure in San Diego, after he signed with the Baltimore Ravens, where he spent 3 seasons before spending the final year of his career before retirement with the Los Angeles Rams. Weddle is a member of the 2010s All-Decade team and was a 5-time All-Pro and 6-time Pro Bowl nominee. Going back to the dominant lineman theme, we drop down to the 86th pick in the third round, where the Ravens took Marshall Yanda. Like Staley, Yanda had a great career, all with the team that drafted him before retiring this past offseason. Both were members of the 2010s All-Decade team, but Yanda was even more dominant in his career than Staley. Yanda won a Super Bowl in Baltimore and was an All-Pro 7 times. Additionally, he was an 8-time Pro Bowl nominee, and he is a member of the Ravens' Ring of Honor. JaMarcus Russell is one of the biggest busts in NFL history, and the trajectory of the Oakland Raiders franchise would surely be different if he had panned out. The Raiders missed big and lost a chance at some of these future star players. I mean, come on, just imagine Calvin Johnson or Adrian Peterson suiting up for the Raiders. But they took Russell. Thanks for watching. If you love JD Productions, check out JD Hoops, where we just uploaded our first video. Go subscribe and hit that notifications bell, and follow us on Instagram and Twitter for more JD. We read all of our DMs and love hearing what you have to say.